Hello everyone, my name is Michael, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to build your tower garden. There are two different types of tower gardens, did you know that? You have a residential model and a commercial model. You get the residential model off of towergarden.com. These are people who are usually buying just one or maybe two towers. You know, they have them in their kitchen or dining room and grow some awesome food. To get the commercial model, you actually must buy 9 or more from a certified distributor through somebody like me or Agrotonomy or another influencer in the space. It's actually then classified as a tower farm. They're not that different from each other, but the commercial model does come with some additional touch-ups that I'm also gonna give you some tips and advice on. So first, let's go over the hardware that you should have if you bought a tower garden. The first is this green basin. This is what the nutrient water sits in. Then you should have got this large white disc that actually sits on top of the green basin. You should have got a pump. You should have got a lot of steel rods. These are these first two long ones, which go in first, followed by some smaller rods. You also should have got like a timer. You should have got some net pots. And I'm going to talk about these two things a little bit. And then lastly, you should have got all your tower pots that are going to stack all the way up. But everything else, like the rock wool, the pH up, the pH down, your nutrient solution, I'm not going to talk about those things in this video. Okay, now for the tower farms. The few other hardware that you're going to get is one going to be your gravity tank, which holds your nutrient water. You're also going to get some white tubing, which is going to feed the nutrient water from the gravity tank to the tower gardens. You're also going to get these little tubes, which are going to puncture the big white tubing, which actually feeds it from the tube into the tower garden. And then you're also going to get these hookups for what's called a float valve. Your green basin should have 3 holes, and the hole closest to the largest hole is where you're actually going to you just screw them together. One end you're going to wrap in some like sealing tape, screw this little cap on, and then you're going to be able to put this float valve in the inside. And essentially what that's going to do is whenever your tower is full, it's just going to shut the valve. And as it is used by the plants, that will automatically allow water to feed in from the tube into the tower garden. Another note here about your pumps, you are going to get an extra tube to this. There'll be like a T-joint, and another tube is gonna go right in the side. Now this is supposed to make it easier to empty your tower garden if you ever needed to. Do not like this, okay? My advice, unscrew that T-joint, pull it right off, forget about it. I've just had so much trouble trying to get these pumps to stand upright when you have that second tube in there. I mean, even if it's fallen over, it still will work just fine. But it's just more difficult to me. It's just way easier for your brain. Everything, just have one tube from the pump into the base. And if you do ever need to empty your tower garden for some reason, just get another pump, get another hose, and you can drop it in anytime you need and pump it right out to where you want it to go. Tower farms are also gonna get this big fancy piece of tech called a dosatron. I'm gonna show you how to set this up. You also should have got this extra watering tool. We're gonna talk about how you could use this. And last but not least, you should have got a bunch of different screws and washers. Now, in my system, I did not get enough washers, all right? Even for the residential, maybe you didn't get enough. If you ever go buy more of these 1/4-inch washers, get the stainless steel, not the zinc. This I got from Home Depot, all right? That should cover all of the hardware. Let's get into building it. Okay, so first thing to do is gonna be to build this. Now, when you have these little pots here, do you notice these little grooves? Notice these little grooves here? So these grooves are going to fit into the grooves of this big white disc. So the best way to do this is to have some type of a tool that's not too hard, and you actually wanna kinda hit it into those grooves. This is going to be the foundation for the whole tower, so you want them in. Check down at the seams. If you see space in one side versus the other, just try and get them even. Try and get them in. You just want to make sure that the pots are sitting in those grooves nice and firm. Okay, next you're going to have these 4 screws, which are going to screw down, connecting the pot to this white disc base. And one thing you're going to notice about these pots is that they always have two holes. One, two, one, two, one, two, except for the holes that the screws are going to go in. Then you're only just going to have one. So you see how you have two here, but then only one there. Two here, but only one here. So you're going to line those one holes, one, one, with the holes in this white disc. Once you have it in, go ahead and take either a screwdriver or a low power drill and go ahead and screw those in. Quick note here, in my towers, those screws do not screw all the way in. And if I did screw them all the way in, it would apply too much pressure and probably snap the pot. I've even heard drilling them in that you hear a little crack, like a little crack. You don't want to crack them. So screw them in until it's tight and firm. Don't over screw it and just expect the screw to go all the way in because you could in fact break it. Okay, now once that's done, we are gonna go ahead and put in the first two long steel poles. So quick note here about this long rod, and I got my camera here so you can see it close up. You see the space between this wing nut and the bar, those little tiny rivets. You wanna remove all that. Make sure this is screwed all the way up, because this little quarter inch, if you have this like this and you tighten this, that little quarter inch is gonna result and the rods not reaching in the pots to where they need to be screwed down, which you're about to see. So you need that screwed all the way down, all the way down, so that there's no space between this bottom wing nut and the bar, okay? Okay, now let's put in these rods. You'll notice in the pots, you have an inner rim, this inner circle, and an outer rim. What you wanna do is find the A hole and then put the rod in the inner rim's A-hole on both sides. So one there, and then directly across in the A-hole on the inner rim. Make sure to have a washer on the outside and the bottom when you screw it in. The easiest way to do this is to go ahead, take your base, put it on its side, slide it in, your washer on the top and the bottom, and then go ahead and screw it in. Okay, once those are in, go ahead, put it on top and let's move on. Okay, next we're gonna attach your pump. This is going to screw right into the center of this disc. The easiest way I found to do this is you're gonna take this tube, position it in the center, and then just spin it to the right, like a top. You're just gonna screw it on. Once you get it nice and tight, you're gonna go ahead, take them both, slide it in. The power cord is going to go out the biggest hole in the green basin. Now, in order to stand the pump upright in the space in your disc, you're just gonna go ahead and reach in and stand it up and suction it down. Then you're good to go. Okay, now we're gonna start threading the pots down the poles to build the tower. If your base is set up correctly, you're gonna start by threading in the B hole. And just like we did with the base, we are also going to use a tool. What I do is I just put my hand on that center tubing and I just hit every single side, make sure it's in nice and snug. And then with the rest of our pots, we're literally just alternating between the A hole and the B hole all the way up. Okay, now once you get to this level, we're gonna go ahead and slide on one more, tap it in. Now is when you're going to need these rods. Now, these rods are essentially just going to screw on the end of the two long steel rods, and we can keep building from there. Take two of these washers. I'm gonna go ahead and put it around those holes and then start screwing in the rods so that we can keep building. Another thing that I'm gonna recommend here is that to make sure that it's nice, fit, and tight, you can sort of pull down on the end that a rod is on and just try and get another little screw. And on the other side, we'll pull down and screw. Okay, now my towers are built to be 11 pots high. If you have more rods or when you ordered, especially a commercial system, you could go even higher than this, but mine are going to stop at 9. And this is why I was telling you at the very beginning, make sure that your long rod is screwed all the way down into that wing nut because you have just a quarter inch of space up here to go ahead and cap it off with your shower cap. If you did not do that correctly, they're not going to reach the whole way and you're not going to even have the room to screw these on. Add our washers, wing nuts here, and screw it in. Pull down on one side, get another screw. Pull down in the other, try and get another little screw. You're going to take your little shower cap here, put it on, and we're done. And if you haven't already, go ahead and put your cover to the thing on. And for you tower farms out there, this is also when you can take your white line here and put it in. So the float valve will automatically allow water from this to come in and fill it up as it gets used. All right, so I got the one set up and now I'm going to build all of them. Let's go. All right, once your towers are set up, it's time to fill them with your nutrient water. Whether residential or commercial, I believe the formula is exactly the same. Just make sure you have the ratio right for the residential. And we'll also talk about how the Dosatron works for the commercial. So let's go ahead. All right, for the tower farmers, this is the Dosatron. I'm sure you've read the manual. The water line just comes in here. It doses from the nutrient bins, and this is what goes out to the gravity tank. So a few things to talk about here. As it runs, you're basically just gonna be pressing these to bleed out any air in the hoses. But most importantly, let's talk about this, the ratio. For indoor farming, you want both of these to be at about 300. See, I have it between the 200 and the 500. For indoor farming, you want that at 300. That took me so long to find when I was setting up mine. And for the tower farmers, as I'm sure you read in your manual, you're also going to get this hook up here to the gravity tank. You're going to take your white larger line, it plugs right into this. And you're gonna run this through down to the towers. I can show you how I did mine here. I ran it all the way through. Mine right down the center of where my towers are between them so that I can then take these fuel lines and plug them in just like I did here so it'll fill up automatically with the float valves on the inside. You have a gravity tank. What I would recommend is the nutrient water you have coming into the tank, I would add just a Y adapter here. So that you can split that nutrient water off. I have an expandable hose here that you can then use this separate shower tool they gave you. And this is useful because now I can go ahead and manually fill these towers, which would just take a lot longer if it was gonna fill through the lines from the gravity tank. And by doing this, you could also use this nutrient water then for whatever you want. So I would recommend doing this. Definitely a cool feature and hack. All right, so this is the timer that you should have got with a tower garden, including the commercial version. These are the new ones. They're really nice because all you have to do is you'll go ahead, we'll plug this in. And then you see how it's blinking O? All we want to do is push it to the I for indoor. I for indoor, O for outdoor. So when you set it, you're done. All right, now that the towers are built, we're gonna go ahead and put in the net pots. But before we do that, we're gonna test and make sure that the water is in fact pumping to the top so that it can trickle down evenly and correctly. All right, so it's looking like this one is doing very well. Pumping nice to the top. You should see the water coming through, perfect. But this one is not, water's not pumping to the top. This is what I'm talking about. If we had put in the net pots and filled it with the rock wool cubes, then it would have been done and they wouldn't have been getting watered, right? So you need to check that now. Go ahead, take this one down, try again. If it's not pumping correctly, it could be due to a pump issue, which I'll talk about here. You see in the front of the pump, there's this little knob. You turn it to the left, it lets more water through, turn it to the right, and it sends less water through. So you don't want it to be hitting the top panel here at the top.
And I'll show you some examples, but this panel, you just want it to be coming just out so that it can trickle down. But if that is not what is preventing the water from getting to the top, it could be your base is not in tight enough. Sometimes I see the water will just, the pressure will spurt out down here under the tower. Or just somewhere along the line, it's just not as tight as it should be. And you have to take it apart, do it again. I've had to do it many times. So let's. Okay, I can't believe I'm about to say this. I just rebuilt this tower twice and I couldn't figure out why it wasn't working. Guess what it was? I looked down the inner tubing. Guess who put this in there? One of my kids. Oh my gosh. Okay, new tip. Check the inner tubing, okay, right here. Check that to make sure that your kids haven't shoved something down it. Okay.
Oh. Okay, now that that's done, we are going to go ahead and put the nap pots in. And now that that's done, we're gonna go ahead and transplant our Rockwell cubes into the towers.
All right, I have finished transplanting everything into the towers. If you have done this, you're officially ready to go. Just be sure to maintain your temperature, your humidity, test the water pH so that you can grow the best possible plants. I hope this video has helped you get started with your tower garden. I love this technology. I think you will too. If you've enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. If you want to learn more about dealing with water indoors, check out this video. And I really appreciate you watching. I'll see you in the next one.